said market failure is what? Your calls went firm. Market failure, your calls went firm. Firms fail to deliver economic efficiency. Remember, economic efficiency is what? Allocative
resources.
Allocative efficiency.
Allocative efficiency and productive efficiency.
And productive efficiency. So when firms fail to deliver these two, then we can talk about what? Market failure. That's why before that say, market failure exists whenever free market, free from what? Government intervention. Government doesn't interfere in what they do. Government leaves them, allows them to do whatever they have to do. Free to use the device, that means they are able to use whatever capital equipment they have, whatever technology they have, they are free to use them. But still, couldn't optimize scarce resources. At the end of it all, they were unable to use the scarce resources judiciously. Then there's market failure. Yes. That means they are unable to deliver to customers as a trade deal, and they can't even reduce their own cost. This is market failure. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay? So using any technology, it is when the interaction of supply and demand in the market does not lead to productive or allocative efficiency, like I just explained. Is that clear? Okay? Continue now. So there are various reasons why market failure occurs. Okay. Why do we have market failure? Reasons, okay? Reasons for market failure. Reasons for market failure. Okay.
Okay. Were there externalities present in the market? The provision of the merit and demerit goods. The provision of public quality.
Let's take it one at a time. Where there is what? Where?
Externalities. There are
externalities. Where there are externalities, okay?
Present in the market.
Where there are externalities. Present in the market, right?
Yeah.
Present in the market. So what are they trying to say? I have to explain immediately, okay? What is externality? Externality means your action has caused what? Effect, either positively or negatively, to the third party. So whatever you have done as a firm has affected either the other side or you. You get my point?
Yes.
You want that. So whatever you have done has had a positive impact on firms, has had on individuals or firms, or has had a negative impact on individuals or firms. So this is externality. We call it spillover.
Okay.
Externalities means your action or inaction has caused damages, has caused a damage, or has caused benefits to third party. It does not only affect you, it affects everyone around you.
Okay.
So if it affects everyone around you, then it's externality.
Yes, externality.
Do you understand? So we have two types of externalities. We have the positive externalities and negative externalities.
You either benefit or more damage.
Damage.
Okay.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Can I write about it now?
Yes.
Okay. So that one is externality. The second one. The second one is.
Second one. The provision of merit and demerit goods.
The provision of merit and demerit goods. So.
The provision of merit and demerit goods.
So what are we saying here? If firms are able to produce merit goods. Normally, merit goods are being produced by government. What are merit goods? Goods that without the consumption of, without the intervention of government, we can't all have it. That is, we can't all consume them, either in service or in goods. That's why we call them merit goods. Example, education. Just imagine or assume that we don't have government schools. So will everybody be able to afford private schools?
No.
No. So that means most of those that won't be able to afford the private schools won't go to school. So but government has interfered by providing government schools or public schools. So it makes education for all. So is it that you have a choice? You have to go to the private school or you go to the public school. Mm-hmm. Do you get the point here? So this service the government provided or produces is what we call a merit goods.
Right.
So they are merit goods because without the intervention of government, we all can't have them. Like health. Mm-hmm. Do you understand merit goods here?
Yes. Right.
Then that is a positive externality, or that is a positive effect. But when the free market or the firms or the private firms produce or provide us with demerit goods, goods that can be harmful to our health, then we talk about what the market fear.
Demerit is the one that is not good, okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yes.
When they provide us with merit goods, we call it's not a market failure. But when they provide us with demerit goods, then it becomes a market failure.
Okay.
You see how we judge them? We judge them based on what the provision they make for us. We judge them based on the services they offer. We judge them based on the products they produce. Is it clear?
Yes. So even the firms, they can have a provision for demerit goods.
Yeah, like cigarettes, yes. Like tobacco,
yes.
Like alcohol.
Yes, for demerits, yes, of course. The third one is the provision of public and quasi public goods.
The provision of public and quasi goods, okay. So, the provision of public or quasi goods. What are public goods? Goods that are non-excludable. It's not for someone, it is for everyone. These are goods that are what? Public goods, like security, national security, like electricity. It is for everybody. So, it is not exclusive. It's non-excludable. That means it is not just for someone, it is for everyone. You understand public goods here? They want to talk about quasi goods. Quasi goods are just like, they are almost like public goods, but they are not. They will become private. Example, like the side beach. The beach you go to, beach.
Yes, yes.
It is for everyone, right?
Yes.
But we can make it for some people by maybe charging higher prices.
Okay.
Do you understand? So, such products, they look public, but in practical, they are not. They look public. But in practical, they are not.
Yes.
Do you understand the difference now?
Yes.
Public goods are for all, non-excludable.
Without the beach.
What?
Without the beach. Example.
Another example?
Yes.
Like the stadium, the national stadium.
Oh, okay. Okay, yes. Yes.
The national stadium, maybe the country has a football match.
Okay.
But not all Libyans can go to the national stadium to watch.
Yes.
Why is it like that?
Because
you have to pay a certain amount of money.
Yes.
And there are some criteria you have to follow. So it looks public, but they are not public. We call them quasi goods.
Quasi goods.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Fourth one, information failure, right?
Information failure, yeah.
So when you talk about information failure, what does it mean? It means firms give or offer details that would result into damage or harm to the health of consumers. So when you give certain information that you're not sure about it, but you gave it out, like a doctor prescribing some drugs to the patient, which he or she is not sure of.
They give a wrong prescription.
Wrong prescription. Oh, probably. He presumed or assumed that the patient understood what he was saying or she was saying.
So what did he consider?
So the patient misused the drugs. That is also misinformation. So misinformation doesn't only come from firms, it could be from the consumers too.
What can damage me? Huge damage what they can do.
What?
Can my damage be my health and I'm the worst for it? What I can do? Huh?
Well, you see, go back to the doctor.
No, but you will not be compensated. It might cause a huge damage in my health.
Well, that is not talking about compensation. We're not talking about that now.
Oh, okay.
So, adverse selection.
Adverse selection. Or moral hazard.
So when you have adverse selection or lower hazard, what does it mean? This occurs when there is discrimination which will come with private pricing or allocation. So when you are putting some people aside based on inference, that's an adverse selection. You're putting them aside based on inference. Mm-hmm. Or you give them a certain price and you're not giving this one the same price. That's an adverse selection. Is it clear?
Adverse selection.
Is a monopoly power in the market.
What do you mean by pricing or allocation resources? Generally, how does the moral hazard relate to adverse selection?
How does price discrimination?
Yes.
Relates to.
I mean, the moral hazard and the.
Yeah, moral hazard is they make you feel. Uh-huh. They make you feel you are not part of the society. They make you feel you don't have the purchasing power.
Like Louis Vuitton.
Yeah, Louis Vuitton, yeah.
Yeah. Louis Vuitton.
Louis Vuitton.
And just give me a few time to learn.
Stop by the business. Abuse of monopoly power in the market. What does it mean? This occurs when firms use all the characteristics. Or when monopolists, don't use firms, let's use monopolists. When monopolist uses all the characteristics of a monopoly to manipulate firms, to manipulate customers, let's say customers, to manipulate customers. So monopoly is a free market, it's a market that belongs to just one person, a single producer of goods and services. So when you are able to portray all the characteristics, when you are using all the characteristics of monopoly to manipulate consumers, then you are abusing the power. So because you are the only one producing, you increase the price. Because you are the only one producing, you let customers don't have knowledge about what you sell. Because you are the only one producing, you restrict supply. These are abuse of power. It's a market failure.
Market
failure. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes. So abuse of monopoly power in the market means you are the best in the market to produce.
You are not the best. You have the exclusive rights to produce. You are the only one that will produce in that market.
Yes.
Let's say you produce laptop. So no other firms will produce laptop except you.
So no one needs to produce laptop.
Example.
Yes.
So it means when you now use all the monopoly characteristics to manipulate consumers, then it's a market failure.
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes.
So you are right.